Hello?
After playing through and thoroughly enjoying 3 out of 10 Season 1, I figured I'd had my fill with these interactive movie-style games. But Cyanide and Happiness Freakpocalypse poked me from the get-go. The second I saw its launch trailer, I knew I had to play it. I knew nothing of the source material, other than the humor often being compared to South Park's. It didn't matter though, because developer Explosum has done a terrific job in selling Cyanide and Happiness Freakpocalypse as a sprawling, action-packed adventure. And at points, it is. Though what you see isn't always what you get. Cyanide and Happiness Freakpocalypse does a few things flawlessly, but I'd bet the last shred of happiness I have on how you'll feel once the credits start to roll. You'll sit there, scratching your head, confused as to where the rest of it is. Our protagonist, teenager Coop McCarthy, doesn't necessarily have a story you haven't heard before. Coop is an enormous loser in the eyes of his teachers, peers, and parents. Routinely the subject of ridicule and merciless beatings, Coop dreams of one day breaking out of his shell and becoming the hero he envisions himself as. It's a run-of-the-mill premise as far as originality goes, I'll admit. Though I found myself quick to forgive the writers right around the time I was asked with finding yeast to help brew prison toilet wine, and finding said yeast in the girls' bathroom. Freakpocalypse had me giggling from start to finish. It's crude, it doesn't care about your feelings, and I love it. The pace at which the jokes are delivered rarely falters, and as such, I was never waiting long for the next batch of laughs to begin. The humor won't be for everyone. So much of what sells the Cyanide Happiness property as a whole is its willingness to push sensitive people to their limits, after all. I'm fairly confident in saying there will be at least a few moments in Freakpocalypse that will put you in stitches. I just wish there were more of them. I may not have rummaged through every clickable tidbit that Freakpocalypse has to offer, but I went through a substantial number of them. Even still, my playtime didn't pass 4 hours. Others may squeeze a few extra drops out, but you'll be hard-pressed to get more than that. The story that's here feels like much of a calm before the storm situation, and if that's the case, I can't blame the developers for following through with their vision. However, this first installment ends with a bang, and Explosum is in an interesting position to build an entirely new type of game based on the finale. They'll have to, because if the sequel plays like Freakpocalypse, Coop may be out of a job. After racking my brain, I can't remember a single objective that wasn't some sort of fetch quest. There may be a puzzle sprinkled in here or there, but they're embarrassingly simple and never feel like anything more than a slight speed bump in your mission. If Explosum took the time to create puzzles that required an iota of brain power, they probably could have extended the runtime by a few hours. If puzzles weren't a possibility, they should have drummed up a few different minigames. Anything to give the player a chance to feel as if they're doing something new. Lesser games would have crumbled under this pressure, but to my surprise, Freakpocalypse manages to hold up due to some stellar optimization. Yes, you'll be doing the same thing over and over again, but at the very least, Freakpocalypse runs immaculately on the Switch. The art style is simple yet bright and beautiful, and genuinely comes to life once in motion. Whether you are in docked or handheld, the framerate remains consistent, with only a stutter here or there. I was worried that the Switch wouldn't be able to handle Freakpocalypse as well as it does. I know that sounds silly, but I've seen games that look so much worse absolutely cripple the system. It's not always a unique or challenging, but damn it, Freakpocalypse is a shining example of how every Switch game should hope to perform. Cyanide and Happiness Freakpocalypse isn't going to blow you away. It's certainly not going to have you reaching for the medicine cabinet though. I suppose much of what you get out of Freakpocalypse will depend on your ability to take a joke. The gameplay won't be what keeps you coming back, but Coop's story has much left to be told, and I'll be there for the sequel. The rub is that if Explosum doesn't bring their A-game for episode 2, I'll probably take a swing at Coop myself.